How can you create a social media analytics report for your clients? Hello everybody, in this video we're going to talk about how you can create a social media report, what kind of metrics to look out for, what kind of tools you can use, and how to deliver it then to your clients. If you're new to this channel, I would love for you to subscribe and hit that like button if you like the video. This channel is all about social media management, and how you can get clients as a freelance social media manager. Now, when you have those clients, you want to give them a report showing off your work, what kind of results you've gotten for them, and how they have grown their business through social media. Now, I want to share with you some of the reports that I have created in the past that you can recreate for your clients, but I also want to share with you what are the downside of those specific reports and why I'm not actually suggesting using them for every single client. So let's dive into this report that I have created for my clients. You can see here, I just have a small cover photo sharing what kind of account it is for. And I'm just going to share this, the Instagram data. I've actually used the Instagram data for my own account to show you guys. And you would duplicate this for Facebook, Twitter, TikTok, whatever you're reporting on. So you just have like a little nice cover. And then we're going to dive right in with Instagram. And what I like to do on the first page is right away give them a summary. I have just added some random text here. That's obviously not what it should say. And also you should add the correct numbers here. I've just blurred that out for now. But basically you give them an inside overview, which you can do. I'm going to share that as well. You can go on Instagram and then click on professional dashboard, and on there you have an overview on what's going on. You have account reach, you have interactions, and then you have followers. So account reach and interactions, basically interaction is engagement. Account reach is how many people have seen your content. Now a lot of the time there's a misunderstanding between impressions and reach. So reach is the total number of people who have seen your content. An impression is usually a bit higher. So let's say you see an ad several times, so it gets several times an impression, but really it reaches the unique amount of people who have seen that ad. So then also the follower grows. Now the follower growth is not the most important metric, but I still like to add it into my report just as a quick overview. And then as you can see, I've added a random text here, but 1, 2, 3 would be your 3 main takeaways from this month. And this is now super important. You wanna share not just what is the number, but why is this number either higher or lower? So for example, if the account reach has gone down massively, could it be because there's been a major political happening in the world? Or is it like Black Friday and the competition is just super high? You want to add that as well. This is super important. Then I want to share with you why that is just plain numbers won't do you any good. So here, this is just a random report I found online, and you can see, even if you have this nice graph, okay, great, we have grown our Facebook likes and LinkedIn followers, etc., etc., but what has actually helped us achieve this growth is way more important. So back to my own report, I am going to share, just because I like it, I usually share the top post either by saves or by comments, whatever you choose, just to give my client an overview like, hey, this post here had 116 saves. And now I want to also highlight that there have been 16 actions taken from this post. So 16 people in this case went to the website. So that is also super helpful, because then we can see that one of these people convert, that they actually convert into a sale. So then here you see the top posts by reach. Again, how many people have we reached? And then how many people have engaged? So the interactions with this post. Then we have key takeaways and KPIs. So what is the overall thing that has happened in August? And you would fill that, or whatever month you're in, fill that whole thing up, which is just a bit more in-depth compared to here where we only had the three things. Now, this is all nice and good and it looks super fancy, but really what's missing, and a lot of people make that mistake, and the reason why I share this whole report is because I did that in the beginning as well. It doesn't really share the KPIs. So what were we looking for? What was our target? And then what was the result? And it doesn't share either what it is compared to the months before or even to the year before, because some months can perform really different than others. Again, like November with Black Friday or December with the holiday season will perform completely different. So now you've spent so much time creating this nice reporting, but it doesn't actually do you that any good because it doesn't give the client a complete overview. So another way to report those numbers is in a spreadsheet, and now you can see it's right away way more in depth, so it's way more advanced. I have an overview of all the KPIs that I do want to achieve. So you would add the KPIs here. What is our goal? What do we want to achieve? And then you add the numbers for each month here. Now, we obviously don't want just the monthly number for ourselves. I like to check on a weekly basis. So that is why we have a more in-depth part here. Now, I'm not going to go into detail with this one here. This is just something that you can think of. So that would be your second option. So your second option would be to have a reporting in a spreadsheet that is way more in-depth. And then from there, you can see clearer what has been going on. Are we on track or are we not on track? Now, what I like to do overall is always to have a call with a client. No matter whether you do it as a Canva, again, I don't really suggest it unless you go way more in depth, but it takes so much time. You can use a spreadsheet or you can just simply use the spreadsheet and go on a call with your client and explain those key takeaways. Downside of the spreadsheet is obviously people are way more in tune to graphics. They want to see like that graph that I showed you in the beginning. So obviously the downside is when you only have a spreadsheet is that you don't see the graphics. Like we saw here in the beginning, these graphics obviously look very easy to understand. So what can you do now if you want to have a mix between the spreadsheet that we have here, which looks super complicated and overwhelming for a client, and also have some super simple graphics like here. One tool that you could use is called Google Data Studio. It's for free, and all you do is go to datastudio.google.com. You have your data sources, you enter it here, then you can create those reports. Here's like an example report from Google that shows you how it can bring the data together. Obviously, what is super helpful, you can also connect it with Google Analytics and have the website clicks or the sales on there as well. Another tool that you can use is called Infogram. I actually quite like it because it's a bit more simple than Data Studio from Google. And what you're going to do is you're going to sign up for a free account and then you're going to choose any of the graphics that you want to create. You're gonna click upload file or you're gonna plug in your Google Drive document on here. And then you can change any settings if you want to change any colors. Obviously, I don't want these colors for my client. So I can create graphics like that and connect it directly to my spreadsheet. So that would be another version for you. And then the last one that I really like is Sprout Social. Now, Sprout Social is an overall social media tool and it's quite pricey. So only use a tool like that if you already have several clients and you have the revenue coming in to pay for a tool like that. Now, you can not only do super fancy graphics automatically within the tool, it also has many other options like competitor analysis. You can see the overall growth. You can see right away it does all the numbers that you need for your clients. It has quite a lot of different tools that you can plug in. So that's definitely something you can look into if you are at a different stage. So if you're just starting out, Start with a simple spreadsheet, but connect it and make a graphic anyway. If you want to create a Canva document, you can do. However, it will take you a lot of time, and I would suggest to still do a call with the clients. A few numbers that you want to look out for is, like we discussed, impressions, reach, engagement rate, and followers. These are more like the overall top metrics. Then ideally, you would also want to get the data from your clients, seeing if they had any sales and what the website clicks were, right? So these are the first few numbers. And these numbers you could call overall awareness. So how many people have you reached, impression, follower growth? This is more like an awareness number. Then we want to do the interaction or engagement number. How many people have liked, commented, saved, or shared our content? And then we want to have another category about videos. Now, we all know how important video is and how big it's become. You not only want to share the story views, how many people have actually watched until the end, you also want to obviously report that for every single platform, like Facebook. What was the through play number? How many people have actually played through the video? On TikTok, how many people have watched that video and how long was the average view time for that video? So that would be another category in your spreadsheet, video views, and how has that impacted our business? And if you do paid marketing, then obviously I would do a separate reporting just for the paid marketing. And you want to look at number like ROAS, so the return on ad spend, how much money went into Facebook and how much money came out at the end of the day. Then you want to look at the cost per click, you want to look at the click-through rate, and you want to also look at the conversion rate on the landing page itself to give your clients an idea on how your ads are performing. But most likely, at the end of the day, the client really cares about how much money did I put into Facebook and how much money did I get in the end. So what was my revenue and then what was my total profit? And that is your job to report that so that they actually see, okay, your ads are performing well. Now, because we had this big update with Facebook ads, the iOS 14 changes from Apple, it is harder to report and to actually look what ad has performed well in actually what ad brought us in sales. So you might want to set up some Google Analytics tracking and what we call UTM parameters to check where the sales are coming from. So this is a more advanced topic, which we're not going to go in depth. I just want to summarize again what we talked about on the reporting side. So you're going to create either a spreadsheet or a Canva document where you report numbers like awareness, video views, content interaction, and then you're going to create graphics or just make it visually appealing for your client and ideally also go on a call with them. The last part is the most important one. That's where you share your action steps. When we had this report, we had at the very end key takeaways. That is so important because now you're going to tell your client what you've learned from these numbers. So now that you've looked at all the data, what are you going to do different? And this is something that I again love to discuss on a call. So I'm going to say, look, this specific content piece has done really well. And the reason why I believe that is XYZ. So I'm going to do more of that. And generally, just looking at these different images, I can tell that my audience or your client's audience prefers infographics and quotes. Now, you would also report the Reels numbers and the video views numbers here. And if you see that the Reels number, for example, are way more down compared to any infographics, then that's your key takeaway. Even though everybody on this planet might say, no, Reels is a hot topic right now, you want to then still go on here and look at the data because the data never lies and Perform action based on the data, not on what any trend or any guru might say. So that's the most important step, you guys, that you talk to your clients and tell them, these are my key takeaways, these are my action steps for the next month, and keep them in the loop. All right, guys, I hope this was helpful for you. If you have any questions about analytics or data or not sure about the numbers, make sure you let me know in the comment section below. If you want to get started as a freelance social media manager, watch the free masterclass. The link is below here. And I'm excited to see you in the next video. Bye.